You also did one of my favorite songs of all time, and millions of people's favorite songs, Something, by the Beatles. How did that come up? And then we would love and be honored to hear you play that for us.
Well, I've always been a huge Beatles fan, and you know, to be honest, a lot of the, I mean, with every artist that I got to work with on this record, you know, I would ask them, you know, if they had a song in mind that they wanted to do.
Right.
And the reason for that is because, you know, I wanted to make it as easy and comfortable for them as possible. You know, I didn't want them to have to learn anything new, you know, or if, you know, or have to work out a new arrangement, you know, cause I could, you know, and that's why a lot of the songs, like even with Ziggy Marley, we did, you know, All You Need Is Love, because he was doing that in his live shows.
Yes.
Same thing with John Anderson, you know, like a Day in the Life. And actually, John Anderson plays a little bit of ukulele. So he sent me a little clip of him kind of strumming and singing the song. So, you know, so that I could kind of get a feel for what he wanted.
What a thrill.
And, but yeah, with this song, you know, I remember talking with Vince Gill about doing something together. We had tossed some different songs around, but then he mentioned Something, and then he said, yeah, if we do Something, maybe I can have you know, his wife Amy sing a duet with him. And it blew my mind, because I thought, wow, I've never heard that sung as a duet before. And when they do it, it just melted my heart. I mean, it's so beautiful, two of them singing together. And then Vince's guitar solo on the song is so awesome.
Oh God.
I just love his guitar solo on that. I mean, you know, because we played it live, and I remember after he played his guitar solo, I was like, I want to redo my solo now.
Wow. It's like, hey,
do this again. Yeah.
That's funny.
He's so brilliant.
Well, he just got off.
He is so brilliant.
He just got off the road with the Eagles, or at least they might be continuing to tour. They just played DC and got rave reviews. Why wouldn't they? But Vince is such a wonderful talent. And actually, Jake, there's a book coming out about the Birchmere. It's called All the Roads Lead to the Birchmere, and it's something that you should take a look at. It's the history of the Birchmere, and Vince is a stellar part of the book, because he is such a tight relationship. So again, the Birchmere comes up again and again. You will be there on November 22nd, and I will be going to your place, Hawaii, the day you're playing at the Birchmere. So I'm like, damn it! I was like, well, at least I'll be going
to switching places.
Yeah, at least I'll be going to where you know Jake lives and breathes his world. Anyway, give us a little bit if you would, and thank you so much for that little kind of piece of it. But this is a beautiful classic song that Jake did with Amy Grant and Vince Gill, called Something.
Yeah. All right.
I have tears, and I'll just say that immediately. That was absolutely spectacular. You got me, man, right in the soul. And not only because it's you, and I love you, and I love the way you have taken what you love and made it such a world-class piece of music in this land, but also Paul McCartney played that song on ukulele the last time I saw him. He dedicated it to George, and it wasn't that full-fledged, beautiful ukulele I just heard, but it just brought back so many memories to me, and the fact that you would play that today for us, and also it's on the new record with Amy Grant and Vince Gill. Jake, thank you so much for being a part of Living On Music Soundcheck today, man. This has just been an absolute joy for me.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much for the support. Thank you.